Hello students, welcome to the session of chance and probability. Probability means possibility. It is a branch of mathematics that deals with the occurrence of a random experiment. The value is expressed from 0 to 1. Probability has been introduced in maths to predict how likely events are to be happen. The meaning of probability is basically the extent to which something is likely to happen. This is the basic probability theory, which is also used in probability distribution, where you will learn the possibility of outcomes for a random experiment. To find the probability of a single event to occur, first we should know the total number of possible outcomes. Actually, what is probability? Probability is actually a possibility only. In everyday life, almost everything that we see or do is subject to chance. The occurrences of events like earthquakes, cyclones, tsunami, lightning, epidemics, etc. are unpredictable only. Most of the events occur quite unexpectedly. Probabilities always pertain to the occurrence or non-occurrence of events. Now, we are going to discuss random experiment, trial, sample space, equally likely outcomes, event, mutually exclusive events, favorable outcomes, and finally, the main definition of probability. Actually, mathematicians use the words experiment and outcome in a very wide sense. Any process of observation or measurement is called an experiment only. For example, newborn baby is male or female, tossing a coin, picking up a ball from a bag containing balls or different colors. These are the examples for probability actually. The main thing is here we are going to discuss chance and probability. We face many situations where we take a chance and it does not go as per our wish. There exist many situations when the chances of a certain thing happening or not equal. Chances and probability are related to real life. The use of probability is made in various cases in real life. For example, during elections, an exit poll is taken which gives a rough idea of chance of winning of each candidate. And predictions regarding poll are made based on it accordingly. Here we have used a small part of the group to find the characteristics of a large group. Here we are going to discuss first one is random experiment. What is random experiment? Random experiment is one in which the exact outcomes cannot be predicted in advance or before conducting the experiment. We are going to play something or we have to conduct some meeting, anything. We can't finalize the event, no. So, a random experiment is one in which the exact outcome cannot be predicted in advance. The next one is trial. Each repetition of the experiment is called a trial only. The next one is sample space. The set of all possible outcomes of a random experiment is called a sample space. Suppose we have to coin a toss once. What are the possible outcomes? The one is head, another one is tail. We have two chances only. So n of s is equal to 2. Next one is event. One or more outcomes of an experiment make an event. And the next one is equally likely outcomes. Outcomes of an experiment are equally likely if each has the same chance of occurring. Suppose we toss a coin once, we have two chances only, head or tail. Both have equal chance. Mutually exclusive events. Two or more events are said to be mutually exclusive if the occurrence of one event prevents the occurrence of the other events. Events can't occur simultaneously. But suppose A is one event, B is one event. And the two events, you just see the common elements between the two events means that is no common elements. That means actually mutually exclusive events. So, A intersection B is equal to MT. And the next one, favorable outcomes. The outcomes corresponding to the occurrence of the desired event. Suppose E is an event of getting an odd number in rolling a die. Then the outcomes are, we get 1, 3, 5. Next time means it is favorable outcomes to the event E. The next one is a formula. The main formula in probability of an event A. Number of favorable outcomes divided by total number of outcomes. So, the formula P of A equal to N of A by N of S. In this chance and probability concept, this is actually related to real life only. These examples are regularly we are using in this chapter. The first one is coin, the second one is die, and the third one is playing card, and the fourth one is color ball. A coin is very simple concept only. Suppose we tossed a coin once, we get two chances. The first chance is one is tail, another one is head. Suppose we tossed a coin simultaneously means we get two chances. The first chance is actually both are heads. Another one is both are tail. One time head, one time tail. One time tail, another one is head. So the chances are four. And the next one is die. Suppose we rolled a die once means we get six chances. The chances are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the sample space value is 6 only. The next one is playing cards. Actually in playing cards, for every shape we are having 13 cards. The first one is Hatin, Diamond, Spade, Clever. Actually in red color we have 2 shapes and black color we are having 2 shapes. For every shape we are having 13 cards. So 13 into 4, the total card is 52. The orders are actually K, Q, J, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, A. The last one is actually as card only. So totally we have to use 52 cards. Using this example, we are going to discuss the problems very simple. Exercise 5.3, first problem. List the outcomes you can see in these experiments. The first one is spinning a wheel. Actually when spinning wheel is given, some letters are mentioned here, that is A, B, C, D and E. We have to mention the outcomes only. What are the outcomes in the first subdivision? Actually A, B, C and the final one is D. This is the answer for the first subdivision. And the second subdivision, tossing two coins together. So two coins together means we are having four chances. The first time we get both heads, second time we get both tail, first time head, next time tail, first time tail, next time head. So these are the outcomes of the tossing two coins together. Second problem, when a die is thrown, list the outcomes of an event of getting a prime number, not a prime number, a number greater than 5, a number not greater than 5. Actually we have to mention the outcomes only. Suppose a die is thrown means what are the possible outcomes? Suppose we just take the values A. Possible outcomes are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. These are the possible outcomes. What is our first question? The first subdivision, a prime number. In this, what are the prime numbers actually? First subdivision answer, prime number only. 1 is neither a prime nor a composite. 2 is only one even prime number. Then another one is 3. The third one is 5. So the prime numbers are 2, 3, 5. Next subdivision, not a prime number. Not a prime number means we have to take a value 1, 4, 6. And the third subdivision, a number greater than 5. A number greater than 5 means we are having only one value, that is 6 only. A number greater than 5. 6 only. The last subdivision, a number not greater than 5. Not greater than 5 means we have to mention all the value. That's all. Third problem, find the probability of the pointer stopping D in given figure. Actually one spinning wheel is given, the wheel is actually rotating. Suppose the pointer stopping D in the given figure, we have to calculate the probability of the particular point D. So first we have to calculate the number of outcomes. What are the values given? A, B, C, D and another one is A also given. So the possible outcomes is 5 actually. We have to calculate the pointer stopping on D only, one outcome only. So the probability of the pointer stopping on D is 1 by 5. First write the given. There are in all 5 outcomes of event. The pointer stopping on D has one outcome. We have to calculate the probability. No, what is the probability formula? Number of favorable outcomes divided by total number of outcomes. So P of D equal to N of D by N of S, number of events in D and the whole sample space value. Actually whole sample space value is 5. Here we get the point D value is 1. So the probability of the pointer stopping D in the given figure is 1/5. And the second subdivision, probability of getting an as from a well shuffled deck of 52 playing cards. Actually the playing cards whole value, sample space value is 52, because we are having 4 shapes, in each shape we have 13 cards. So 13 into 4, the whole value is 52. Here we have to calculate the probability of getting an as from a well shuffled deck of 52 playing cards. So how many as cards in every shape? We are having 1 as cards, so total cards are 4. So probability of getting an as from a well shuffled deck of 52 playing cards is 4/52. So probability of getting an well shuffled deck of 52 cards. So P of something you have to mention, A means P of A equal to N of A by N of S. Here number of events in A is actually 4. The total value is 52. So 4/52. We have to cancel this value. No. So these two values are multiples of 4. 4 ones are 4. Balance 1. 4 threes are. So the answer is 1/13. And the next subdivision, probability of getting a red apple in the figure. Actually one figure is given. Here how many apples given? 7 apples are given. We have to calculate the number of red apple. In this actually red apple 1, 2, 3, 4 only. Total apples are 7. Probability of getting a red apple actually 4/7. So we have to mention probability of getting red apple. P of B equal to N of B by N of S. Actually N of S means sample space. What is the whole sample space value? 7 apples. In that red apple is actually 4. So the answer is 4/7. That's all.